Whatever the time may be for class 9 students, today we are going to start cell organelles. Previous day in lecture 8 we have discussed nucleus. Today we are going to discuss this cell organelle, endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is a large network of membrane, bound tubes and sheets for the transport of materials. Second point, there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum and a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Here, whenever we talk about rough endoplasmic reticulum, then on the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum, if ribosomes are present, it is called rough endoplasmic reticulum, and if ribosomes are not present, it is called a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Then there are two types of endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum and a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum looks rough under microscope because it has particles called ribosomes. Here ribosomes are dot-like structures, are ribosomes attached to its surface. The ribosomes, which are present in all active cells, are the sites of protein manufacture. Here protein is manufactured. It is important to know. The manufactured proteins are then sent to various places in the cell depending on the need, using the endoplasmic reticulum. Next point, the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, SER, helps in the manufacture of fat molecules or lipids, important for cell function. Clear? Now, in the next point, some of these proteins and lipids help in building the cell membrane. This protein and lipids, which are formed by a smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum, helps in building the cell membrane. This process is known as membrane plasmolysis. You should know this term, membrane plasmolysis. The formation of plasma membrane by the help of a smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum, it is called membrane plasmolysis. Some other proteins and lipids functions as enzymes and hormones. In the last point, you should know, in the vertebrate liver cells, vertebrate, you know, having vertebral organisms, having vertebral column. In the vertebrate liver cells, a smooth endoplasmic reticulum plays a crucial role in detoxifying many poisons and drugs. It is a special feature of the liver cell of vertebrates. If poison or any drugs enter in our body, it tries to detoxify poison and drugs. In the next cell organelle is Golgi apparatus. This cell organelle is also important for you people, and you must remember all these characteristic features which are given here. The first point, the Golgi apparatus, first described by Camillo Golgi. No problem. Second, Golgi apparatus consists of membrane bound vesicles arranged approximately parallel to each other in stacks called cisterns. Here these are arranged in parallel order and it is called cisterns. These are called vesicles. It is a vesicle. It is a diagram of Golgi apparatus. These are stacks one over the another called cisterns, and these are called vesicles. Next point, these membranes often have connection with the membrane of endoplasmic reticulum. The material synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum. The material synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum is packaged and dispatched to various targets inside and outside the cell through the Golgi apparatus. You must learn, the material synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum is packaged and dispatched to various targets inside and outside the cell through the Golgi apparatus. Next point, its functions includes the storage, modification and packaging of products in vesicles. Next point, the Golgi apparatus is also involved in the formation of lysosome and cell plates. We will discuss next day about lysosome and cell plates. It is the diagram of Golgi apparatus. Here in plant cell, it is formed of separate units called dictyosomes. In plant cells, it is formed of separate units called dictyosomes. From the endoplasmic reticulum, it may be connected to both. In the first point, the endoplasmic reticulum is a large network of membrane-bound tubes and sheets for the transport of materials. It may be connected to both the outer nuclear membrane as well as plasma membrane. Whenever we talk about transport, endoplasmic reticulum serve as channels for the transport of materials, especially proteins, between various regions of the cytoplasm or between the cytoplasm and nucleus. It also functions as cytoplasmic framework, providing a surface for some of the biochemical activities of the cell. And which cell, here some questions may be asked like that, which cell organelle is actively involved in membrane biogenesis? Which cell organelle is actively involved in membrane biogenesis? Here, answer will be endoplasmic reticulum. Next question, which cell organelles play a crucial role in detoxifying many poisons and drugs in a cell? Again, it is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum in the vertebrate liver cells. Next question may be from this, what would happen to the life of the cell if there was no Golgi apparatus? From this, what will happen if there will be no Golgi apparatus in the cell? Here the answer may be, there would not be any lysosome because it is responsible for formation of lysosome, for intercellular digestion and cleansing. no complexing of molecules, no excretion and no formation of new plasma membrane. Dear students, we always busy in this teaching learning process, but we must know some moral things. Today I am going to tell you people चाणक्य नीति से मैं कुछ डिस्कस करने जा रहा हूं. दैट इज एसेंशियल जो आजकल के माहौल को हम लोग देख रहे हैं. चाणक्य ने कहा पुत्र या पुत्री वही है जो माता पिता का भक्त है, माता पिता वही है जो पुत्र या पुत्री का पालन पोषण करता है, मित्र वह है जिस पर विश्वास हो. माय डियर, शिक्षा ही समाजोपयोगी समाज दे सकता है जिससे राष्ट्रीय चरित्र का निर्माण संभव है. राष्ट्रीय चरित्र के लिए एक अच्छे माता पिता, अच्छा संतान, अच्छा मित्र का होना आवश्यक है जो शिक्षा के द्वारा संभव है. शिक्षा का उद्देश्य चरित्र का बनाना है जो वस्तुतः जीवन के प्रति एक प्रकार का दृष्टिकोण होता है. एक विचारक स्माइल्स ने कहा डे लाइट कैन बी सीन थ्रू स्मॉल होल्स सो लिटिल थिंग्स विल इलस्ट्रेट ए पर्सन्स कैरेक्टर. अर्थात सूरज का प्रकाश छोटे छोटे छेदों में होकर देखा जा सकता है. इसी प्रकार व्यवहार की छोटी छोटी बातें व्यक्ति के चरित्र को प्रकट कर देते हैं. उक्त संदर्भ में हमें विचार करना चाहिए कि हमारा व्यक्तिगत आचरण राष्ट्र की छवि का किस रूप में उजागर करने वाला है. एक बार स्वामी विवेकानंद जापान में रेल यात्रा कर रहे थे. उस दौरान वे फलाहार करते थे. एक रेलवे स्टेशन पर विवेकानंद खिड़की से झांक कर इधर उधर देखे तो उन्हें फल विक्रेता कहीं नहीं दिखा. वे पास वाले पैसेंजर से बोले कि क्या जापान के रेलवे स्टेशन पर फल नहीं मिलता है. 2 मिनट बाद वह क्या देखते हैं कि एक आदमी फलों से भरी हुई टोकरी उनके सामने रख देता है. उनको फल विक्रेता समझकर विवेकानंद जी मूल्य पूछने लगे. उस आदमी ने विनम्र भाव से कहा आपको फल चाहिए, वह हाजिर है. आप भारत वापस जाने पर कृपा करके यह ना कहें कि जापान के रेलवे स्टेशन पर फल नहीं मिलते हैं. सचमुच अपने देश के सम्मान का ध्यान रखना राष्ट्रीय चरित्र की विशेषता है. पूर्णतः शिक्षित इच्छा का नाम चरित्र है. यह चरित्र ही वस्तुतः व्यक्ति की वास्तविकता होती है. इस परिप्रेक्ष्य में हम यदि भारतवासियों के व्यवहार पर विचार करें तो हमको निराश ही होना पड़ेगा. भारत पाकिस्तान वार के समय भारतवासियों ने तस्करी के द्वारा भोजन सामग्री भेजी थी तथा जासूसी की थी. ऐतिहासिक दृष्टि से भारत में विदेशी आक्रमणकारियों को भारतवासी ही आमंत्रित करते रहे हैं. यानी चांदी के चंद टुकड़ों के लिए देशद्रोह करते हुए कुछ भारतीयों को तनिक भी संकोच नहीं होता है. यदि कोई व्यक्ति कहे स्वार्थपरता एवं देशद्रोह भारत का राष्ट्रीय चरित्र है तो हमको अपने दुर्भाग्य पर 2 आंसू बहा लेने चाहिए. तो तुम लोगों को इस चरित्र निर्माण के बारे में भी अपने माता पिता से भी डिस्कस करना चाहिए. थैंक्स फॉर टुडे. थैंक्स अ लॉट.